Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will look at some things you can do if your printer is offline and how you can change the status to online. For a more in-depth look at the issue, be sure to check out the article in the description down below. Let's check a few basic things first. Is the printer plugged into a power source? Is it turned on? Next, if it's plugged into your computer, is the cord connected? If it's on Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, is your Wi-Fi or Bluetooth on, and are the devices indeed on the network? At this point, if the printer is on, try turning it off and then wait a minute or two and turning it back on. Let's also consider running a couple troubleshooters. Open Settings. In System, go to Troubleshoot. Other Troubleshooters. In Windows 10, that's called Advanced Troubleshooters. The first one we wanted to do is run the printer troubleshooter and follow any of the on-screen prompts. The next troubleshooter that you would run is if your printer is on a network. Click on the network troubleshooter and follow any of the on-screen prompts. After that, restart your system and see if the problem is fixed. Next, let's try and change the printer status. Go to Settings, then look for Devices. In Windows 10, you would be looking for Devices. In Windows 11, Bluetooth and Devices. Then Printers and Scanners. Select the printer that you're after and click on Open Print Queue. Click on Printer and for Use Printer Online, click on it. You may or may not have a confirmation status. If you do, accept it and then check and see if your printer is off online. Finally, if you're still not able to correct the problem, then your best bet might be to uninstall the printer and reinstalling it. To do this, start by unplugging the printer. Then go to Bluetooth and Devices or Devices, go to Printers and Scanners, select the item, and click on Remove Device. Restart your system and plug the printer back in. Windows should add the device back and install the driver as well. If not, you may need to go to the OEM website to download the driver. This should correct the problem. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.